What's up, everyone? Welcome to the Power Play with CJ. As many of you guys saw from the videos here and the pictures I tweeted, I went out to Erie, Pennsylvania this week to take in a little junior hockey. I went out with my dad. I started planning the trip, I want to say, 3 months ago, 4 months ago. And the original trip, I was going to interview Jacob Chychrun, who plays for the Sarnia Sting. Erie was playing Sarnia in Saginaw this weekend, and I sent a message to Chychrun. He said, "Yeah, man, absolutely, I'd love to." And then it's kind of scheduling conflict. The World Under-17s happened this weekend. He was playing for Canada. He's hurt in the tournament, but you know, it's with the team nonetheless. So obviously, a great honor of your country. I was bummed out by it, but you know, it's the nature of the beast. He was really apologizing. You know, little apologize for you get a chance to represent your country. That's an amazing thing. You know, don't worry about the hockey slash smut blogger over here. I'll be all right. You know, and so we went out to Erie. My dad and I lay over in Philly. Barely made the flight from Philly to Erie. When I say the door was closed. We begged to get on that plane. We got to Erie and, you know, go over Friday night to the game. And the consensus was, all right, I'm not going to get an interview, but I'll get to watch some amazing hockey, do the, you know, the draft diaries on it. I'm going to break down the games and the prospects in another piece. This is more about the backdrop, the experience being out there. So we're at the game Friday, and I wanted a McDavid jersey. I wanted a blue Connor McDavid jersey. It's important to remember. So I was kind of looking at, like, they had white ones. The blue ones were too small for me. So we started watching the game. McDavid puts on a little bit of a clinic in the first period. And so I went up at the end of the first. Like, you know, I told my dad, I'm just going to get a white one. Cut my losses, right? Got the white XL adult jersey. Walking down. I was walking to pay for it. And there's an issue with the computer which is important to remember, the computer at the cash register. So I was talking to the guy in front of me in line. This guy, Jerry. I was thinking of Larry Robinson for a minute. But Jerry from Toronto, huge Habs fan, by the way. We're kind of just chirping each other. I had my green sweatshirt on, just talking hollow hockey. And him and his wife had kid-sized blue jerseys. I said, "You know, I wish I made that in my size." You know, just kind of, yeah, I wanted the blue one. I wanted the blue one, man. So I bought the jersey, and I said, you know, we're talking, going out, and he goes, "Would you want to get that shirt signed?" It's like, "What?" He goes, "After the game, do you want Connor to sign that for you?" I was like, "Yeah, I'd really, really like that." And he's like, yeah, absolutely, man." That's what I said to him. I was like, "Yeah, whatever." He goes, "Come meet me at such a place. I'll take you down." I was like, "Oh, my dad." He goes, "Yeah, bring your dad. We'll go down. We'll meet the guys and whatever." So my dad got back to my seat. I'm like, "How lucky to feel right now?" He says, "Why?" I was like, "We're meeting McDavid after the game." So that's Friday. Game goes on. They beat Sarnia 5-2. McDavid had, I think, 3 assists. He was just, you know, on another level. You know, really just putting on a clinic out there. We go down after the game, and we're waiting for the Otters to come out. There was a massive signing that nobody told the team about, that they were kind of ticked off that they had to do. So we're waiting in the visitor's locker room, and Dylan Strome walked in. My dad and I took a picture of Dylan Strome, projected top 5 pick. And, you know, he was a really nice kid. And, you know, one thing led to another. McDavid, the line for McDavid was going around the arena. So the guy Jerry says to us, "Introduce you to Sherry Brasson, the artist general manager." So he introduces us, you know, "You guys are from Boston. How's that guy, that kid Noah Hanifin? He's pretty good from what I heard." It's like, "Yeah, he's an amazing hockey player. And, you know, obviously, you know, the projected top 3 pick." So we're kind of talking. He goes, "You come to the game tomorrow night?" "Yeah." He goes, "Come on down and we'll get you in. We'll get Connor to sign the shirt for you. No big deal." So I was like, "All right." So Saturday at the game, watching it, McDavid puts on absolute clinic. The thing was a goal and 3 assists against Saginaw. I got asked by someone in the arena if I wanted to answer an Erie Otters trivia question on the Jumbotron. Right, this guy Mike, really good guy. So I go on the Jumbotron. They put a picture of a player up there, and it was named that Otter when they were a kid. It was Corey Genovese, the team enforcer. He had boxing gloves on. It should have been a dead giveaway, but of course I screwed it up. But which comes into play later too. It's a great experience. We go down after the game. I said, "You know, Sherry sent us." Like, "Oh yeah, the 2 guys from Boston, go right in." And we're waiting for McDavid to come out. The guys from Saginaw are walking out to the bus. And, you know, bags are pretty cool. The Saginaw Spirit hockey bags, but. McDavid came out, and I was like, I was in awe. I brought some Power Play with CJ shirts. I don't go to those things empty-handed, but I gave him a shirt. He signed my jersey, and I was like, we just kind of talking for like, 60, 90 seconds. And he's like, my dad shook his hand and said, yeah, I think you're the real deal. He goes, I watch Jack Eichel play a lot, too. And McDavid looks at my dad and goes, yeah, Eichel, he's a pretty good player. It's like, that's awesome. And, we got the autograph, got some pictures. He got a shirt. Everyone, it was just a great experience. And it was just dumb luck that it all happened the way it did. And then walking out, we bumped into Genovese. And he was a great kid to talk to. And, he was also just an awesome guy. My dad shook both the hands and said, I hope you guys win the Memorial Cup. And the consensus answer was, yeah, we hope we do too. But we had a great time out there, and it was just an amazing experience. And, I didn't get an interview with McDavid, but I really wasn't out there. I didn't get an interview. I was just going to tell you what I could get. And being able to give Connor McDavid a shirt and, get an autographed jersey by him that I'm going to treasure for the rest of my life. And, I just really enjoyed some amazing hockey and some really, really talented young players. Was awesome. He was a great kid. Dylan Strome's an amazing young man, and as is Corey Genovese. So the Erie Otters organization, from top to bottom, from Sherwood Grassman, the general manager, down to the players, is one of the most classy establishments I've ever seen. And, I really do hope they win the Memorial Cup, because the guys out there deserve it. They're awesome players, awesome hockey minds, and just a great outfit to be there. So real successful weekend in Erie. Anyway, that's on this episode of The Power Play with CJ on the big weekend in Erie. Stay tuned for episodes for the season and beyond. Later, guys.